Hillary Clinton is involved in a bizarre beef with Democrat Tulsi Gabbard. Apparently, Clinton thinks that Gabbard is some kind of Russian agent. Mitt Romney is on the attack once again against President Trump, and Robert Francis O'Rourke signals his support for National Period Day. All that and more. I'm Bobby Eberle. This is a 13-Minute News Hour.
And God bless the United States of America.
All right, friends, welcome to the show. I hope you had a great weekend. For me, it was awesome. The Astros are on their way to the World Series starting tomorrow. It's going to be great, but we've got a lot of news to cover too. So first of all, there is this beef going on with Hillary Clinton and Democrat Tulsi Gabbard. She is the representative from Hawaii, who's one of the Democrat presidential candidates. And for some reason, Hillary Clinton decided to go after Gabbard in a very bizarre way. Here's a report from CNN.
Hillary Clinton is suggesting that Russians are grooming a 2020 Democratic presidential hopeful to run as a third-party candidate and spoil the race for the Democrats.
So did you get that? Hillary Clinton says that the Russians are grooming one of the current candidates under the Democrats for president to later run as a third-party candidate just to doom the Democrats' efforts in 2020 against President Trump. It sounds like a movie, grooming a current American, a Democrat, to support the Russians by turning the elections for President Trump. And the person she thinks is behind it is Tulsi Gabbard.
Take a listen to her remarks in a new podcast from David Plouffe.
I'm not making any predictions, but I think they've got their eye on somebody who's currently in the Democratic primary and are grooming her to be the third-party candidate. She's the favorite of the Russians. They have a bunch of sites and bots and other ways of supporting her so far.
So it's Russians. Russians, it sounds like a movie. Russians are infiltrating American politics on the Democrat side. One of these candidates that appears on these debates and is running for president is actually a Russian agent, a Russian spy that's going to turn and bring this election once again towards Trump to doom the Democrats. This is what the Russians are trying to do, according to Hillary Clinton. So, of course, Tulsi Gabbard doesn't take this, you know, sitting down. She's fired up. She's wondering what's going on. So she fired off some tweets over the weekend saying, "Great. Thank you, Hillary Clinton. You, the queen of warmongers, embodiment of corruption, and personification of the rot that has sickened the Democratic Party for so long, have finally come out from behind the curtain. From the day I announced my candidacy, there has been a concerted campaign to destroy my reputation. We wondered who was behind it and why. Now we know. It was always you, through your proxies and powerful allies in the corporate media and war machine, afraid of the threat that I pose. It's now clear that this primary is between you and me. Don't cowardly hide behind your proxies. Join the race directly." Oh my gosh. So that was, I mean, she didn't mince any words. She came right out at Hillary. And again, part of that is got to be anger. Part of it has got to be surprise, like what is going on? And that surprise is taking a lot of Democrats and the media. They're just wondering what's going on. Here's Van Jones over at CNN wondering what this is all about.
You can't be proud when we can't have a primary without the former nominee jumping on a podcast, throwing out aspersions, and then we're in a tweet war. This, we got real problems in America. But I'm telling you, Hillary Clinton is playing a very dangerous game. I do not want somebody of her stature to legitimate these kind of tactics against anybody.
So that clip is really interesting. On just a little side note, the longer clip, and he even alludes to it there, he's talking to a CNN anchor. And whenever he refers to this race or the Democrat Party, he says, "we," like out in our. Our party did this, or we need to do this. So it just is just a subtle little indicator of how CNN is just in the tank for Democrats. But the bigger idea is that Van Jones is wondering what's going on. I mean, the host, when you watch the interview, is like, yeah, Hillary's saying this stuff. It's really strange. But the backlash was intense against Hillary Clinton, so much so that her spokesman, Nick Merrill, put out this tweet saying, "Folks, listen to the podcast. She doesn't say the Russians are grooming anyone. It was a question about Republicans and CC's Van Jones." Of course, she did talk about the Russians, and she says that it was the person being groomed is one of the Democrat candidates. That's what she said. We just heard her. So what's going to happen next? What's going to happen with this beef between these two? It's so bizarre. Well, the New York Post is reporting that coming up this Friday, there's supposed to be an event that had Hillary Clinton and Tulsi Gabbard. Well, Clinton bailed on that one. Here's the report. It says, it looks like the queen of warmongers blinked. A face-to-face confrontation between Hillary Clinton and Hawaii Rep. Tulsi Gabbard set for next Friday was averted when Clinton backed out of the Fortune Most Powerful Women Summit in Washington, D.C. Clinton aide cited a scheduling conflict when she announced her withdrawal from a speaking slot at the annual event. One insider told Slate that Clinton dropped out to protest the inclusion of former Homeland Security Secretary Kristen Nielsen on the schedule. But Gabbard is on the bill, too. And Clinton's pullout came just hours after the former Secretary of State on Friday accused the Hawaii Democrat of being a favorite of the Russians on a podcast. All right. And so to amp it up even more, Tulsi Gabbard put out a video on Twitter just yesterday going after Clinton and the entire corrupt Democrat machine. Check this out.
But if they can falsely portray me as a traitor, then they can do it to anyone. And in fact, that's exactly the message that they want to get across to you. That if you stand up against Hillary and the party power brokers, if you stand up to the rich and powerful elite and the war machine, they will destroy you and discredit your message.
Yep, and so it continues. And the question that what's going to be interesting to follow in the next few weeks is this going to help Tulsi's campaign? I mean, she's definitely gotten some media attention out of it. Will this give her a bump in the polls? Will it help her in fundraising? Who knows? I mean, we're going to report on it. We're going to follow it. But the bigger question to me is, what is going on in Hillary Clinton's head? I mean, is she looking to jump in the race by pretending to be coaxed by Gabbard when Hillary's planning this the whole time? And calling someone an American politician, a Russian agent, is just beyond bizarre. I haven't seen anything like that before. So we're going to follow that. But now I want to move on to Mitt Romney, because he is at it again. And this guy is such a tool. And I hate to call anyone that, but he just did an interview with Axios, and it was broadcast on HBO yesterday. And when someone is asked by a left-wing organization to come on and blast the president, the leader of your own party, and you do it, then guess what? Yes, you are a tool. And Romney, he wastes no opportunity, skips no opportunity, doesn't pass on anything that allows him to blast President Trump. And he did it once again. Here's a clip. Here's part of the interview from Axios on HBO.
What is the single dumbest thing he's done?
I think the places where I would be most critical of the president would be in matters that were divisive, that appeared to be appealing to racism or misogyny, and those are the kinds of things I think that have been most harmful long term to the foundation of America's virtuous character.
So see, this is what I mean. Romney allows himself to be a stooge of the left. I mean, this guy is like, what's the dumbest thing that President Trump's ever done? And Mitt Romney's like, oh, well, I've got an answer for you. I'll just jump right in here. I won't try and correct that language or say that that question's inappropriate or turn it in any way. He just goes ahead and answers it. And that's what he does over and over again. And here's more from the interview from the Washington Examiner. It says, in a Sunday Axios HBO interview, Romney, who has feuded with Trump, gave his theories on why other Republicans in Congress aren't as vocal in speaking out against the president. There's no upside in going on out and attacking the leader of your party, because they're just going to let someone come in and primary you on the right. So people want to hang on to their jobs, he said. But there's another reason which is more elevated, he continued, and that is people genuinely believe, as I do, that conservative principles are better for our country and for the working people of our country than liberal principles, and that if Elizabeth Warren were to become president, for instance, or if we lose the Senate, that it would not be good for the American people. All right, well, here's the thing. Yes, That's absolutely right. So why do you keep doing it, Mitt Romney? Why do you keep going on and on and attacking not only the president of the United States, but the leader of your party? Because every time you talk about that, it puts ideas into people's heads and it makes people more likely to vote against Republicans and for people like Elizabeth Warren. So this stuff you're saying about why other Republicans might not be speaking out as much, what about you? You're actually doing it. You're hurting our chances. You just said it could help elect someone like Elizabeth Warren, and yet you're doing it. It's absolutely ridiculous. But again, Mitt Romney passes on no opportunity. We're going to see him next on probably a guest host on MSNBC or something like that. So he could take a whole hour, not even an interview. He could just host his own show blasting the president and then wonder why, you know, things that people are voting for Elizabeth Warren. It makes absolutely no sense, but he does it over and over and over again. So, and speaking of someone who makes no sense, I want to talk to you about Robert Francis O'Rourke, because he was posting some weird stuff again, and it's in relation to National Period Day. And in case you didn't know what that was, this was Saturday. No one knew what it was. And it's not a day in honor of our most cherished of punctuation marks. Nope, it's not that when we're talking about National Period Day. So he and some of the other Democrats, you really get a feel for with this issue, where who's on the top tier of the Democrats running for president and who's on the bottom tier struggling and pulling out any issue out of their hats that they think will resonate with someone. Well, Robert Francis O'Rourke is one of those bottom tier ones, and he decided to speak out on National Period Day. He tweeted this. He says, "In detention centers and in prisons, in big cities and small towns, women across America don't have access to the period products they need. On National Period Day, men need to join women in demanding real change, which is why I'm supporting the Menstrual Equity Act." Okay. This is real, okay? This is what he tweeted. PJ Media had a story about this act and some of these presidential candidates that were tweeting over the weekend, and here's their report. They said, "And yes, it appears that the Menstrual Equity Act is a real thing. H.R. 1882, otherwise known as the Menstrual Equity Act for All Act of 2019. Apparently, Beto thinks women across America have never heard of a pharmacy. Oh, but wait, this absurd legislation isn't just for women. According to GovTrack, this legislation will increase the availability and affordability of menstrual hygiene products for individuals with limited access and for other purposes." Yes, men need this too. And we've seen stories about this before where they are now putting the feminine hygiene machines in men's restrooms because with the transgender movement, men can have periods too. And O'Rourke jumped on this. Cory Booker and Julian Castro said that taxpayers should be footing the bill for these types of products. So what's next? I mean, razors and shaving creams and other personal hygiene items? They just want to up the taxpayer bill. And to me, it just shows the desperation when Beto and these others are tweeting about this stuff. So anyway, that's the outrageous moment for the weekend. I hope you enjoyed the show. That's all our time for today. Please subscribe. And when you do, please hit that bell so you'll be notified. And we'll see you next time. I'm Bobby Eberle. This is a 13-Minute News Hour. Okay, friends, just a little reminder before you go, and no, this does not count against my 13 minutes. Please hit the subscribe button below and tell your friends, and if you happen to miss our last show, you can check it out right here, and also for great conservative news and commentary, please check out GOPUSA.com. All right, folks, we'll see you on the next show. Have a great day.